Hello, my dear students. This is Hina Kausar, and welcome back to the class.
In the previous session, we were discussing the numericals. I hope now you are getting used to the steps which I had prescribed in the very first class of the numericals, right? So, what are those steps? Let's quickly recall those steps. First thing is reading the question completely. Right, until we understand it sentence by sentence question na ode adana correct agi artha maadkobeku and second point is imagining what the situation has been given to you question alli en kottidare adana imagine madidre it will be very easy to interpret the given data so imagine maadadmele given data en ide anta easy agi extract maadabodu so writing down all the given data which is given in the question and the next to the thing is finding the appropriate formula looking at the given data na nodi adakke appropriate aagtakanta suitable aagtakanta formula na navu recall maadkobeku once you get the formula substitute all the values then mathematical simplification once you are done with that final results sigutte final results alli en maadbeku once you are achieving the final results recheck the whole situation andre beginning alli neevenu data interpret maadirthira what you have to found what you have to find whether you have achieved that in the answer you just try to recheck the whole numerical and then keep the final answer with an appropriate SI unit right so these are the steps which we are following in solving numericals let's continue our discussion and move on to the next question so next
charge of 3 × 10⁻⁷ coulomb okay now estimate the number of electrons transferred from which to which okay and the second part of the question is there a transfer of mass from wool to polythene okay since this question has been asked in parts we will simplify it in parts first let us try to understand what is the given situation ಈ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ಕಾಂಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಏನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೆಡ್ ದರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪಾಲಿಥೀನ್ ಪೀಸ್ ರಬ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಊಲ್ ಪಾಲಿಥೀನ್ ಪೀಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಅ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ದರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಬ್ಯಾಗ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಊಲ್ ಅಂದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ನಮಗೆ ಊಲನ್ ಒಂದು ಬಂಡಲ್ ಈ ರೀತಿ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೆಡ್ ದ ಪಾಲಿಥೀನ್ ಪೀಸ್ ಇಸ್ ರಬ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಊಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಆಫ್ 3 × 10⁻⁷ ಕೂಲಂ ಸೊ ಈ ಎರಡು ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ನ ರಬ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ರಬ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಊಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಪಾಲಿಥೀನ್ ಪೀಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೆಡ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಪಾಲಿಥೀನ್ ಪೀಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಅ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಲಿಥೀನ್ ಪೀಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿಕಮಿಂಗ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್ ಏನ್ ಬಂದಿದೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ 3 × 10⁻⁷ ಕೂಲಂ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ನೌ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾಂಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ we have to estimate the number of electrons transferred right when electrons are transferred to a given material then only then the the body will get negatively charged right when the body gets electrons or when it gains the negative charges or when it gains the negative electrons then only it is said to be negatively charged and the polythene piece enagide electrons transfer agirutte from wool to this polythene piece therefore it has got negative charge so we have to calculate how many number of electrons has been transferred from this wool to polythene piece so that it has become negatively charged so that number of electrons we have to calculate eshtu number of electrons transfer agirodrinda ee magnitude of charge ee polythene piece ge bandide adanna naavu calculate maadbeku then we should also mention from which to which ande ಯಾವ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಇಂದ ಯಾವ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಗೆ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಓಕೆ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ಇಟ್ ಯು ಮೇ ಲೂಸ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಓಕೆ ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫೈ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಇಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಪಾಲಿಥಿನ್ ಇಸ್ ರಬ್ಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಊಲ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ a number of electrons get transferred from wool to polythene therefore wool becomes positively charged and the polythene pH becomes negatively charged. This is very obvious from the theory of what we have learned, right? So transferring of electrons is taking place from wool to the polythene piece. Now the amount of charge in the polythene piece, they have given in the numerical. The amount of charge which is gained by this polythene piece is -3×10⁻⁷ coulomb. Let's just write it down. Then the amount of charge on an electron, we know that each electron will carry a charge of -1.6×10⁻¹⁹ coulomb, because electron carries negative charge, therefore it's important to specify negative sign. And fundamental charge value is 1.6×10⁻¹⁹ coulomb, so each charge on electron value will become this much, right? Now let's assume that the number of electrons which are transferred from wool to polythene, that is given by N. Let's just make an assumption. So this N we have to find out. N na navu find out maadbeku anta kelidare. So N can be calculated by which formula? See, looking at this Q, E and N, what formula strikes through our mind? That is the quantization, charge quantization formula. That is Q is equals to N into E, right? So any charge value will be always an integral multiple of elementary charge. That is quantization of charges, right? So that formula will be relevant in this situation. So N we can calculate using this formula. N na now left hand side ikkagondre enagutte, it can be written as N is equals to Q over E. E will go to the denominator. Now simply just substitute the values. Q value they have given, that is -3×10⁻. E value they have imagine that -1.6×10⁻¹ coulomb, substitute it, then simplifying it gives you 1.87×10⁻½. Okay, I haven't done the simplification step by step, because so far I think you have already understood the simplification. Simplification is very simple. Whole numbers na first to calculate maadkoli, adadmele exponentials na separate calculate maadkoli. That will be a simpler way to come to an accurate answer. Okay, so therefore when you simplify this, you'll get the value of N as 1.87×10⁻½. So that will be the answer for question number A. So the number of electrons which are transferred from wool to the polythene bag, that is 1.87×10⁻½. So if these many number of electrons are getting transferred, then it means that much 3×10⁻⁷ coulomb of charge has been acquired. Okay, so that answers our question number A. Now let's move to the question number B. What is question number B? Is there a transfer of mass taking place from wool to polythene? So when we are rubbing these two materials are getting charged. Along with getting charged, along with the transfer of electrons, they have asked whether the mass from wool to polythene gets transferred. Okay. So answer for that question is yes. Yes, because whenever the body is getting charged, it means the electrons are getting transferred, and we know that each electron has certain mass. Right, what is the mass of electron? It is about 9.1×10⁻³⁻³ kg. Although it is very small quantity, but we should consider that small quantity as well. It has certain mass, right? Now the total mass transferred to polythene from wool would be the number of electrons multiplied by mass of each electron. So number of electrons we have already calculated. It is 1.87×10⁻½. And mass on each electron is 9.1×10⁻³⁻. So when we multiply these two things, that gives you the total mass which has been transferred from polythene to the wool, right? So 1.706×10⁻¹⁸ kg. Although it is very negligible mass, tumba kadmi value idru kuda, answer should be yes. Even if it is a small quantity, but the mass has been transferred from wool to polythene. That should be our answer. Okay. So you should always remember that whenever a body is getting charged, it is acquiring. If it is getting negatively charged, it is acquiring electrons. If it is getting positively charged, it means it is losing electrons. In the in the process of getting transfer, the electrons transfer process ali enagta ide, mass kuda transfer agutte. Yake? Because each electron will be having certain mass, right? So therefore this fact should be remembered, and here this answers our question. Now let's read the next question. Next question is, two insulated charged copper spheres A and B have the center separated by a distance of 50 cm. Okay, so what is the mutual force of electrostatic repulsion if the charge on each is 6.5 × 10⁻⁷ coulomb? The radii of A and B are negligible compared to the distance of separation. Fine. And the second question is, what is the force of repulsion if each sphere is charged double the above amount and the distance between them is halved? So again, as you see, the question is in two parts, so we will simplify it in two parts. Okay, so first let's simplify the first question. Before coming to the first question, they have given the situation. Situation na avaru kottidare. So aa situation na first imagine maadkondu adad mele first question na simplify madakke try madana. Okay, so first situation en kottidare, two insulated charged copper spheres. Let us imagine these are the two charged insulated copper spheres. They are charged and as well as insulated from outside, which means they will not get charges from outside since they are insulated. Okay, so let's imagine A and B are two copper insulated charges and their centers are separated by a distance of 50 cm. And the first copper sphere center in the mattondu copper sphere, that is copper sphere B center vargu extra distance kottidare, they have mentioned it as 50 cm. So the distance R is 50 cm. So question all note takshana neevu you usually what you have to do, you should see whether it is in SI unit or not. Centimeter, it's not an SI unit, so convert it into SI unit. So we'll convert it into meters. So 50 cm meters to convert madidre, we can write it as 0.5 meter, or we can also express it as 5 × 10⁻¹ meter. So that is the distance they have prescribed. Okay, so now let's move to the first question. What is the mutual force of electrostatic repulsion? They have directly asked you to calculate what is the force of repulsion. Okay, electrostatic force of repulsion andru onde, force of electrostatic repulsion andru onde. Okay, ee eradu copper spheres madhyadalli irthakanta force of repulsion anna navu calculate maadbeku. For that they have given the charge value on each copper sphere. Okay, each copper sphere mele charges estide anta helidare, 6.5 × 10⁻⁷ coulomb, which means this sphere charges q1. Let us assume it charges q1, so q1 value is 6.5 × 10⁻⁷ coulomb, and the copper sphere B aduku kuda same charge ide anta helidaru avaru. Okay, so that is having, let us assume that charge is q2 and that value is also magnitude enide same ide, so hagagi 6.5 × 10⁻⁷ coulomb antane togalana. So question alle kottidare, both are having same charges. Fine, so q1 is equals to q2, they are identical. Each anta kottidare, they have specified on each. On each means both the spheres are having same charges. Fine, and also one more sentence they have given. So this sentence you should take it as an hint. The radii of A and B are negligible compared to the distance of separation, which means the spheres what they are talking, they are not of big size. Okay, they are small spheres. Small spheres anta mention mado badlo avaru en helidare, radius of the sphere enagirutte negligibly small ide. Ee distance ik compare madidre idu tumba sannadide, andre you can imagine these as point charges. See, charge value ishtu kadmi ide andre, you can imagine these are the point charges. Okay, so that is just they have mentioned in this sentence. So now let's calculate the force of electrostatic repulsion. Q1 Q2 values is given, distance of separation is given, which means what formula comes to our mind? The it's obvious, the Coulomb's law, right? So charge on sphere A, that you write it in the given data, charge on sphere B, write it and pen down it in the data, distance between the spheres, express it in SI unit. Now take the formula. Formula is F is equals to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R square. See, for the given data, here charge the magnitude value kote dare, distance kote dare, force na calculate maada kheli dare. So this is the relevant formula which comes to our mind. So take down the formula and go on substituting the value. Here in this formula, 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, that is the force constant. We know the value of it, right? So 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught is 9 into 10 to the power of 9 Newton meter square per Coulomb square. That value we know. Epsilon naught is absolute permittivity, or you can also call it as free space permittivity. We know that. So just let's just substitute the value of, directly substitute 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught barely 9 into 10 to the power of 9 substitute madi. Q1 value we know. Q1 value any there? The charge at A. That is 6.5 into 10 power minus 7 substituted. Q2 value is we also know, that is the charge placed at B. That is 6.5 into 10 power minus 7 substituted. Since both are same, we can take it as whole square. Q1 into Q2 anta bariyadu andre eradu identical value ide andre you can take it as whole square. So I have this took it as whole square, whole divided by R square. R square value in the 0.5 meter, right? So 0.5 whole square. So now simplifying this, whole numbers na separate of simplify markoli, exponentials na separate of simplify markoli. When you simplify in that way, you will get the value of the force of repulsion as 1.52 into 10 to the power of minus 2 Newton. So write that result in a sentence, right? Therefore, the force between the spheres is 1.52 into 10 to the power of minus 2 Newton. So this answers your question number A. We have found the force of repulsion between these two spheres, right? And why I took the SI unit as Newton? Because it is force. We know SI unit of force is Newton. So now moving to the next part of the question. Next part of the question is, what is the force of repulsion if each sphere is charged double the above amount and the distance between them is halved? And the same situationally, charge value double adre, matte e distance of separation half adre. Okay, instead of 50, if it is been halved, okay, avaga force en agirutte adanna naavu calculate maadbeku. Okay, let's just imagine, after doubling the charge value enide initially 6.5 into 10 power minus 7 coulomb ide, adu double maadbekandre meaning enu, we have to multiply that value by 2. ಎರಡು ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಕಲ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಎರಡು ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಕ್ಯೂ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಬಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಬಿಕಮ್ 2 ಇಂಟು 6.5 ಇಂಟು 10 ಟು ದಿ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 7 ಕೂಲಂ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಯು 1.3 ಇಂಟು 10 ಟು ದಿ ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 6 ಕೂಲಂ. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಅ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಇಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್, ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೆಡ್, ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ನ ಡಬಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ ಎರಡು ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ, what is the force of repulsion if each sphere is charged double. Each sphere charge na double madidvi, erdu kade charge 6.5 itto, nav en madidvi adanna multiplied by 2 madidvi, so ee value namage bandide. Na innondu condition en kottidara avaru, and the distance between them is halved, andre r value na avaru en madide ardha madidare. Okay, ardha madadandre eno, we should divide it by 2, right? So R is equals to 0.5 meter. We know we have to divide it by 2. So when we divide it by 2, we give the value, we get the value of R as 0.25 meter. Now, in this situation, we have to calculate what is the force of repulsion. Again, what formula we have to use? Same formula. That is the Coulomb's law. F is equals to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R square. Force of repulsion between these two spheres. Now what we have to do, we have to substitute these new values. ರೈಟ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ನ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ನ್ಯೂ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ನ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಒನ್ ಓವರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಪೈ ಎಪ್ಸಿಲಾನ್ ನಾಟ್ ರಿಮೈನ್ಸ್ ಸೇಮ್, ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ 9 × 10⁹. Q1 and Q2 values are 1.3 × 10⁻⁶ into 1.3 × 10⁻⁶. Either you write it like this or you can simply write it as 1.3 × 10⁻⁶ whole square. Both means the same. Divided by R square value is, R value has been taken as 0.25 meter because the distance has been halved. So 0.25 I'll substitute maadi, it gives you 0.25 whole square. On simplifying this, whole numbers na separate simplify maadi, powers na simplify maadi, in that case you get the value as 16 × 1.52 × 10⁻². Further simplifying this, you will get it as 0.243 newton. Okay, so that will be the force of repulsion between these two new spheres, right? Because that has been changed and distance of separation is also has been changed, the context has been changed. In this condition, what will be the force acting between the two spheres? It will be 0.243 newton. So this answers your question number B. Okay, so whenever you come across with such numericals, you should read the question carefully. Okay, part by part pratiyondu condition na kuda neevu ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಡಬಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಗ್ನೋರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಹಾಲ್, ದೆನ್ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಸಮ್ ಅದರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಹಿಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಟು ರೀಡ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಕೇರ್ಫುಲಿ ಸೋ ದಟ್ ಯು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ನ್ಯೂಮರಿಕಲ್.
But uncharged is brought in contact with the first, then brought with the second, and finally removed from both. What is the new force of repulsion between A and B? See, this question is again relating to the previous question. Previous question na we solve madidvo ivaga adakke relate agide, and this is little quite confusing, so listen carefully. Let's try to understand the given context. Okay, so in the first sentence, what they have given, suppose the spheres A and B in question 9 have identical sizes. So let us imagine in the previous question what they have given, two copper insulated spheres they had given. Let us assume those spheres are A and B and they are of identical sizes also. Okay, which means they are having the same charges, 6.5 × 10⁻⁷ coulomb, 6.5 × 10⁻²⁷ coulomb. This was given in question number 9. Okay, now what they are telling, a third sphere of the same size but uncharged is brought in contact with the first. So let us imagine there is a sphere called C. Okay, the third sphere, let us name it as C, which is first touched with the first sphere. First sphere, yaudili, let us say that first sphere is A. Okay, and what they have said, then bought with the second and finally removed from both. Let us imagine that the third sphere C is touched with the first sphere A and then it is removed. Okay, so imagine madbeku, there are two sphere, they are of same size. ಎರಡು ಸೈಜ್ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ಸೇಮ್ ಇದೆ. ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಎ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್, ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ದ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್. ನಾವು ವಿ ಆರ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಎ. ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್, ದ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಅನ್ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಮೂವ್ಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಟಚ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ವಾಟ್ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಡ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ಸ್? ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಮೈಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್. ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಈಚ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಏನ್ ಉಳಿಯುತ್ತೆ, ದೆನ್ ದ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಆನ್ ಈಚ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ Q+0/2. ವೈ? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಆನ್ ಎ, ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ Q. And since the third sphere is neutral, that is uncharged, so charge on C, let us assume that is zero, right?
and when it is touched and then removed, then these charges have been distributed equally on both the spheres. So therefore, Q plus 0 whole divided by 2. Now, after touching and removing, the first sphere and the third sphere has equal amount of charges, that is Q by 2. Andre first sphere mele yen charges itto, a charges enagirutte, ee third sphere, uncharged sphere mele distribute agirutte. So now, after touching and removing, the first and the third sphere is having charges Q by 2 each. Okay? So this is the first situation what they have given in the question. Second situation, alen helidare, read the sentence one more time. A third sphere of the same size but uncharged is brought in contact with the first. Brought in contact with the first, we already discussed here. And finally removed from both. We removed it from first sphere. So that part is over. But then brought with the second and finally removed from both, which means the same third sphere, again now we have to bring in contact with the second sphere, that is B, sphere B, and then remove it, right? So let's see how much amount of charges will distribute over the two spheres, that is the second and the third sphere. So after this, what we have to do? The third sphere C has to be touched with the second sphere and removed, same manner. ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ನ ನಾವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಗೆ ಟಚ್ ಮಾಡಿ ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು. ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ನಾವು ದ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ, ಇವಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಏನಿದೆ, ಕ್ಯೂ ಇದೆ, ದಟ್ ವಿ ನೋ. ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿ ವರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂ. ಬಟ್ ನೌ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟಚ್ಡ್, ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಗೆ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಅಕ್ವೈರ್ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಕ್ಯೂ ಬೈ ಟೂ ಅಕ್ವೈರ್ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಟಚ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಬೈ ಟೂ, ರೈಟ್? ನೌ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರಿಂಗ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ಯೂ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಬೈ ಟೂ. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಇಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಟಚ್, ದೀಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಈಕ್ವಲಿ, ಸೊ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ. So when we divide it by 2, the total amount of charge becomes 3q by 4. Andre erdu spheres mele eshtu charges distribute agutte, 3q by 4. Okay, second sphere mele charge estide ivaga, 3q by 4. Third sphere melu kuda charge ivaga estide, 3q by 4 ulidide. And what about the first sphere? First sphere mele charge estide, q by 2. So this is the condition. ಸೊ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಅನ್ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಬಾಡಿನ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ಗೆ ಟಚ್ ಮಾಡಿ ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಈಚ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದೀವಿ. ಇವಾಗ ನಾವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪಲ್ಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ನೌ ದ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ಡ್. ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಎ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಎಷ್ಟಾಗಿದೆ, ಕ್ಯೂ ಬೈ ಟೂ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ತಗೊಂಡಿದೆ. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ, 3q/4 ಆಗಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಇವಾಗ ಈ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಮಧ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪಲ್ಷನ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಅಗೇನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೂಲಂಬ್ಸ್ ಲಾ. ಓಕೆ, ಬಟ್ ನೋಟಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿನ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ಡ್, ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ರಿಮೈನ್ಡ್ ಸೇಮ್. ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲೂ ಈ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ. ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಪರೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ಡ್ because of the contact of the third sphere with that of the first sphere and the second sphere. So now let's simplify what would be the force of repulsion. So just imagine now the charge A has got the value Q by 2 and charge B, sphere B, has got value 3Q by 4. So adanna nave en maadbeku, the new force of repulsion would be 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught. Q1, Q2 ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಬದಲಾಗಿ ನಾವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು, Q1 ಬೈ 2 ಇಂಟು 3Q ಬೈ 3Q2 ಬೈ 4 ಅಂತ ತಗೋಬೇಕು, ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. ಇದನ್ನ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, 1/2 ಅಂಡ್ 3/4 ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ ನಾವು ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ 3/8 1 ಓವರ್ 4 ಪೈ ಎಪ್ಸಿಲಾನ್ ನಾಟ್ Q1 Q2 ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. ಸೊ 3 3 by 8 into 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 divided by r square, right? So 3 by 8 as it is you can write, and q1 q2 value we know, q1 q2 or q value is 6.5 into 10 power minus 7 coulomb. Idanna namige question 9 in the imagine maadkolakke question 10 alli prescribe maadidru. So the same values if you substitute, and r value is 0.5 meter adana substitute maadi 9 into 10 power 9 ಇದು ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ನಾವು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ನಂಬರ್ 9 ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿದೀವಿ. ಬಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವೇನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಮತ್ತೆ ಆ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ನ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ 1.521 into 10 power minus 2. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಆ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂನ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿ ಬರ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಅದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಫೈನಲ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಸ್ 5.703 into 10 to the power of minus 3 ನ್ಯೂಟನ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪಲ್ಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ these two new spheres. Okay, so this answers your question number 10. Okay, this is little confusing, but no issues if you try to understand the question part by part. Okay, part by part neevu understand martha hodre it will be very easy. As I just mentioned here, it is imagine martha hoge part by part question na imagine martha hodre, so you will easily able to come to the accurate answer. Okay, I hope you understood today's session. We will continue the same numericals in the next session. Till then, take